For many people, the memory of the first time they rode a bicycle is one they will never forget. As children, learning to ride a bicycle meant we could speed up time and shorten distances that up to that point had been measured by how long we could play outside and how fast our feet could carry us. Bicycles are a relatively new form of transportation, first invented about 100 years ago. The heart of every bike ever ridden is something whose history may date back to 3500 BC. This is the wheel. Being familiar with a few simple aspects of how bicycle wheels are built may help you save money or keep you from having to walk home with a broken bike. The parts required for building a bicycle wheel are not complicated and consist of a hub, a rim, 36 nipples, and 36 spokes divided into four groups of 9 spokes each. For this demonstration, the groups have been color-coded. The tools needed are a screwdriver and a spoke wrench. Today's wheel is going to be built by John, co-owner of the Cyclepath Bike Shop in Athens, Ohio. With the rim on his lap, John takes the hub in the first spoke, usually referred to as the key spoke, and after inserting a spoke from outside of the hub flange, John attaches it to the rim. It is important to attach this first spoke next to the hole that is used for the tire's valve stem. The remaining 8 spokes are inserted into the hub with 1 spoke hole between them and with 3 spoke holes separating them on the rim. The first spoke of the second group is inserted into the hub on the opposite side of the key spoke and is attached to the rim opposite the valve hole from the key spoke. The remaining 8 spokes are then attached around the hub, 1 spoke hole apart, and attached to the rim so there are 2 spoke holes between the installed pairs. The first spoke of the third group is inserted on the key spoke side of the hub and attached to the rim so it crosses over 3 spokes. This is known as a 3-cross spoke lacing pattern. The remaining 8 spokes from this group are inserted into the same side of the hub and laced to match the 3-cross pattern like the first spoke of this group. The first spoke of the fourth and final group is laced just like the spokes of the third group, but on the opposite side of the hub. The spoke lacing is now complete. All that remains is for the spokes to be tightened with a spoke wrench, the wheel aligned, and pedaling to begin.